Hello everybody, this is Haiti23 from Avid Gaming. Today we're playing Viscera Cleanup Detail. It's a little alpha game from RuneStorm. This is a game about the cleanup process after like an alien horror film or something. So I think it's really cool. You get a little mop and a bucket, and you get biohazard bucket and a little water bucket, and basically the object of the game here is to basically clean up after what's left of a alien destruction or horror scene. So you see, I'm gonna grab my little bucket here. There's so many cool things you could do. You just clean up all the blood and stuff. And what's cool about this game is they implement, like, once you get your mop all bloody and stuff, you actually can go wash it. So here's some little bullets from somebody shooting or something. But anyway, you take your little mop here and you could actually like wash it up and everything. What's cool about this game is you get your all. It's so strange, you know, who wants to play a game about cleaning stuff up? But it's just the concept that matters. So you're picking up all the remains of people and stuff, and if you drop the remains of people and stuff all over the place, you can actually leave bloodstains everywhere. So as you see here, I'm picking up all the biohazard pieces. So this game is really in depth when it comes to like, cleaning stuff up, and you go. It's not only like body parts you can interact with. You can interact with barrels, and in the corner there's little Chinese rice boxes you could pick up. I don't know why those would be implemented in some kind of a alien horror film. But anyway, the point of this game is just to clean things up. So that's what you do basically. So there's a few things I would change about this game. One thing is I wish you could rotate items. If you grab them weird, you tend to spill things all over the ground. But right here I'm taking the biohazard bin, and you can actually get rid of some of the chunks of people. So this is how you clean it up. You bring it to the little furnace, you open it up, and you just stick the thing inside. I mean, you could dump the pieces in there, that's more efficient, but at the time I was just like throwing things in there, experimenting. But you actually take actual pieces and burn them up. So you can pull it back out, as you see there's still a little more pieces in there, so I kind of throw it back in there. That's why a rotation feature would be pretty nice, that you could rotate it and then like throw the pieces in. But then again, it's only in alpha. You can actually pre-order the game at the site. I'll leave a description down the link. So I'm showing you here, there's a whole bunch of things you can interact with. I picked up a barrel there. It's kind of like the game Amnesia. It's a horror kind of game that you could pick up anything, interact with them. Only with Amnesia, you can actually rotate things, and Amnesia is very good in depth. It's a very good horror game if you want to play it. It's a little old, but if you haven't heard of it, I'm actually surprised. But here I am, I'm just messing with things, you know, checking out the physics of stuff. I was putting stuff in the water bucket. And you see, as I threw it in there, and all the blood inside, like, spilled out and, you know, went all over the place. So this is how you get a new bucket. You go over to this little machine over here, you can plop up a new bucket and plop it down. And, for example, do not spill the water buckets, because you can see here, leaves blood all over the place. So if you spill a fresh water bucket, there won't be no blood. So it's not like it's not always programmed to do the same thing all the time. That's why I like this game. This thing is it gives you a new biohazard bucket. Despite the size of the machine, it gives you infinite biohazard buckets. So that's pretty cool. I wish they could implement it so that like if you break the bucket or something, you have to like go get a new one from somewhere else, because like that's a tiny machine and it kind of holds, you know, infinite biohazard buckets. But anyway, this is where I wish I had a turn feature, because I had to return it, I had to throw it. So it's a little unfortunate. So some of the things aren't perfect, but it is a good game and it is worth it. It's free. I mean, free stuff is cool, right? So anyway, I was picking up all this stuff, and I basically have this room pretty much cleaned up. So I'm Haiti23 from Avid Gaming, and I'll see you guys later.